what's going on YouTube. Delivery time once again. So I gotta climb up here and start throwing some wood in. Obviously this tree is in the way again with all this vine maple hanging off of it. So I might just come and cut a branch. But I'm just trying to work this whole side here so that I can get access, so that I can park the truck and be able to throw the wood in here. And I wanted to clear out all of these crates here first. But I'm gonna start with these two just to give me a little bit of access here, and then I'm gonna start plucking from these ones. I'm also gonna take these empty crates and I'm gonna start filing them up there instead of dragging them all around so that I have access to the next set of wood. Yesterday a lot, and the wood's heavy. The water trickles down through some of the wood, and it even gets through the bottom of the IBC totes and trickles into the next crate under. So yeah, it was heavy, man. But I'm really hating using these IBC totes, but you know, they really help with giving you some extra space, right? So a lot of times I load the wood from the totes into the truck, and I just wonder, how can I do things differently? You know what I mean? My problem is now the smaller space. So it's a little harder on me to get rid of the totes. You know what I mean? I still got to put on some more wood. So I'm going to use up some of that silver maple up in that solo crate in front of the 40-yard bin. Because that 40-yard bin's going out soon. And then I'm going to just trickle these softwood pieces out. I'm just going to put like 3 or 4 in every one of my orders. Because I've had it for so long, guys. And it's just not selling. This customer, as you can see, he's taking a full quart. And then the other guy, he's taking a face quart. So almost done here. I'll just run down the street like, what? It's probably about 8 minutes from here, and then I'll come back, get the other one. It's a bit of a trek. It's rush hour now on Friday, but I'll just take one of the main streets instead of the highway, and I'll get it done. It's not too far from the shop, so once I'm finished there, it's about maybe, I'd say about 20 minutes from the shop, so won't take long to do the other one. Okay guys, just pulling up to the customers, and I was on the main road, Kingston Road, coming down here. And I got a phone call, and there's a guy who saw my truck. He saw the sticker on the back, and he called me and he says, yeah, I'm looking for some wood. So the sticker actually worked. I mean, obviously it's gonna work at some point, but that's the first call I got. So here I am with the customers. It's 2:37, I'm looking for 2:21. This is stopping at the next street here. That guy, he just lives further down Kingston Road, kind of towards the shop ways, and he wants a face cord. Is this in here? No, 227. There he is. He's outside waiting for me. And he wants it on the grass, just like last time. Thank you. a video, but he's got his kids out here, so he doesn't want me to film. So I'll just dump the load and we'll go get the other load on. Just going through the back roads, waiting on the GO train. This carts all the people from downtown heading eastbound. Probably going to take a bit because the station's literally right to our left, so it's either the train slowing down and coming in there, or the train's going out and it's just starting up, so it's going to take a bit to get up to speed before it gets through the lights here. Yeah, it's the eastbound train. Oh, he picked up some speed pretty good. Yeah, in the city, a lot of people, they work in the city, but they live out of town because it's cheaper to live out of town and do the commute. Okay, so my GoPro mount just came out of the camera, so I have to get some more screws. I had one in there, and surprisingly, I found one, so I put the two in, but I don't have the right bit to fit them back in. So they were loose, and they kept getting loose as I was tightening them back in as best as I could. But I just went and picked it up and then it came right off. So I'm actually gonna go change my phone and get that repaired, and the guy will definitely have some screws there and he'll have the tools there, because the phones use the same kind of screws with the Torx bits to get fed back on there. So let me get loaded up and then go do that other delivery. Okay, so I'm gonna start peeling out of this one, and I've been moving some crates up to the top there, and this one, a lot of the rungs, the welds are gone on them, so I'm gonna bring this to a welder just to tack it up. I still gotta find an adapter for my own welder, but you know, I don't really want to cart one crate over to the shop and then back over here. It can be done because I'm back and forth, but whatever. I'll just put this aside for now and then we'll worry about it later. There's a few of them that have been damaged because of the move, and it's nice to have a skid steer to move these things around. But they are brutal on them, you know. You could be a professional with them, but they still take a little bit of abuse. That's always a factor when moving these around. It'd be nice if you could just lay all these on the ground and you just fill them up just like that, right? But like I said, I keep rethinking how to deal with these, and it's an ongoing battle. So let's get loaded up. This actually looks quite small for a face cord, but I did empty out a whole crate, that's for sure. But there's a lot of silver maple in this crate, and I think I remember filling this one up and saying, well, whatever, that's what I have and I can't spread them out, and at the time with the other crates and whatnot. So I'm gonna give the guy a bunch of this stuff here, and I'm gonna just tell him, like, okay, I'm gonna overload you on this stuff, just burn this quickly and get rid of it. You know, it doesn't look so great, but I'm giving you a whole bunch extra. So let's just go from there. It's Friday evening. I don't want to get in. I don't want to be in here too late and digging up more wood in the crate. So let's just bomb a whole bunch of this on and then call it a deal. All right, there it is, guys. Looks like much more than a face cord, so the customer should be happy. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, share, comment, and all that good stuff.